Hello and welcome to Sunday Brunch Live. I'm Tim Lovejoy.
I'm Simon Rimmer.
We're joined this morning by actors William Roach and Sarah Hadland, singer and actor Alexandra Burke, and today's music guest, Ollie, Mikey and Emery, better known as Years and Years. How is everybody this morning? Are we all well? We're going to start off, you're into your healthy living, aren't you? We're going to talk about it later. You've got a book about it, which we're going to discuss.
Ooh,
but,
yes.
But this is your smoothie that you do most mornings.
Yeah, I like to start the day off with some goodies. So three vegetables and a fruit, whichever you want, and put turmeric and a bit of apple cider vinegar in. I don't put ice in normally, that's
right.
In there.
Yeah.
And then you've had your goodies for the day.
You know,
you can never get your five veg in and all that, can you? So you start off feeling
good. We did the ice to stretch the volume out. Budgets are tight, you know.
Is that how it works?
Have a go. Cheers.
Oh, yeah, put the ice in. Yeah. Mm. That's delicious.
It's nice, and it's really refreshing.
And
it's
good for you. That's most things
you
like aren't very
great,
good for you.
Aren't you?
Yes. You
look amazing.
Come on.
You look amazing.
Right, let's see what everyone's been up to this week. Yes, but you performed yesterday at Rise Festival in Chelmsford. There you are.
Oh, look, it's us.
Hey.
We're having such a great time.
How was it? Was it good?
Mm. It was good, thank you, yeah.
How was the weather? It rained a bit yesterday, didn't it?
We were inside a tent, so it was all right for us.
Terrible for all them. William, you've been doing 12-hour days this week on Corrie, we've been told. Is that right?
Well, you can get long days if they go on in the evening. Normally, it's about a 9 to 10-hour day. Yeah, they can be long. And we've got some... With my dysfunctional family, really, working well at the moment, I've got some heavy stuff coming up.
Oh. Do you enjoy it when you get the intense
storylines? You know, the really heavy stuff and the badder you are, the more enjoyable it is. Sadly, but anyway, with my family around me, there's plenty of stories coming up.
Sorry to talk about money, but do you get paid more if you do more work?
Sadly, no.
It's best to do nothing then.
Yeah, if you get a scene with just one line in it and you do that and go home, you get the same money as if you've been weeping and crying and shouting all day.
That's what you want. You've been rehearsing this week for your new show.
Yes, Dance Nation at the Almeida. I never know where to say Almeida or Almeida. But it's one of the two.
Tickets available for both locations.
Yes, both locations, yeah.
Have you learnt your steps and have you learnt your lines?
Yes, fingers crossed.
And when's the first one?
We start on previewing on Monday the 27th of August and our press night is Tuesday the 4th of September and we run until October the 6th. Oh, did that very well.
Nice job.
I'm quite pleased with myself there,
Alexandra, you started Chicago this week.
Yeah.
Do you remember your lines?
I mean, Monday I kind of just went with the flow, really. I knew what I needed to say. It may have come out in different kind of ways, but we got through to the end and that's all that matters. And I've done 8 shows this week. And I'm still buzzing because I don't know how I got through that. But it was great.
Well,
it's been a great week.
Some of your Strictly friends went to see you
Your
show this week. There they are.
Oh.
Do you recognise all those, Simon?
No. They're all dead to me now, Tim. My life's over.
Well, this week Strictly was announced. The contestants, they've started announcing them, aren't they? And they clearly got a new celebrity booker because they've upped they've raised the... They raised the bar off the contestants. They were really digging around in the bottom of the barrel last year.
Should we just leave?
Last year was a triumph.
I can't.
You were doing it this year, Tim. You shouldn't be so disparaging.
Come on,
Halloumi.
Let's
go. Mr. Halloumi. Oh. I'm not, I'm Brie. Anyway, what we're talking about there is the code names, because the code names for this year's Strictly are cheeses.
Yeah.
Your year was...
We were Greek gods.
Yeah. Yeah. Who were you?
I was Bacchus, the god of food.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who are you?
Aphrodite, goddess of love.
Oh.
Yes.
Nice.
Because I just love everybody. Yeah. You know.
They didn't have a god of lead and feet, so I had to go to food.
The god of diving boots.
Oh, that's so harsh. I thought you were very good.
Thank you, Sarah.
He just didn't get to Blackpool.
Every week.
Ollie, you must fancy doing a bit of Strictly, don't you? You can dance a bit.
Do you think?
Yeah. Oh, you'd be amazing on it, Ollie.
Put you in the video here. Look.
Oh,
look.
I'd want. Oh, here we go.
How convenient.
No, but you'd be brilliant.
I'd want a guy partner. Wasn't that?
Oh yeah, that's true.
I think next year it will.
We're not ready this year.
They're going to do it.
So
aren't
just
they?
Doing it.
You want a big man to spin me around.
Yeah.
So that's what you're saying. You'd do it if you get a man partner.
I think. Well, why not?
Yeah. Is that a bit? You want? Yeah, a headline.
Yeah.
Sarah, you ever thought about doing it?
It's always clashed with whatever I'm doing. I have been asked, and it is. I do love it. I think it's the best show. I just love it. But yeah, it's always clashed with whatever I'm.
Alex, what's your best advice for Tim when he starts at the show?
Well, see, listen, hello me. I think, you know, just take each day as it comes and just keep looking at the feet. Yeah. Don't look up. Yeah. Never look up. Yeah. Just make sure your feet are right, and, you know, they'll love you. Because I had pigeon feet, apparently, so...
Would you ever fancy doing it?
No, I'm afraid I've got two left feet. I'll stick to the weeping and the wailing. the heavy dramas with my family.
It also takes up a lot of time. You just took up so much of your time, didn't it?
It's just like a proper full-time job. I don't really like
it.
Must be
learning the new dance. Must be really tough, actually.
It's just non-stop. It's all right if you can dance like Alex can, but when you're like me and you can't...
You made it look really tough, didn't you?
Yeah. I don't understand how people learn dancing. Like, you know, with words, there's a logical sequence. Mm. How on earth do you learn a sequence of steps?
Yeah, I never did.
Today's call-out is inspired by our music guest, as we want to see pictures of things that you've been doing for years.
Hey! That's so clever, yeah,
For example, William, you've been in Coronation Street for years and years. Look, there you are, look around.
Yeah.
Wow.
Fantastic. Yeah. So here's some examples of what we want. Jazz has been singing for years and years. Here she is as a four-year-old at the piano and last month performing at Kew Gardens.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Catherine has been visiting the Isle of Wight for years and years since she was a child in 1982 and now takes her own family. And Pete Pillsbury has had the same picture taken by the same son of Derbyshire for years and years. Since 1992.
Best day of my life.
Keep sending pictures of things you've been doing for years and years to us at Sunday Brunch C4 or Sunday Brunch at Channel4.com. What's on the menu today, Simon?
Right, Ollie and Mikey first in the kitchen, and we've got a grill.
Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We're cooking with Ollie and Mikey from years and years. Before we go, before we start talking to you about cooking, you brought in this for us, which is kind of amazing.
Did we?
What is this? It's you. Who made you this?
We got given this.
Oh, it stands.
Oh, it stands. And then it starts moving. We went to South Korea recently, and at the airport, we had lots of fans waiting for us, and one of the fans gave me one of this. And I wear this outfit in our music video for If You're Over Me, so it's like a recreation. It's amazing. Good, I've actually got two of these.
Got this. It's even got your tattoo on it and everything.
I know. It's attention.
Emery likes to put pins in it.
Yeah, Emery uses it as a voodoo doll.
How is your cooking, you two?
I'm not really the cook, am I? But you cook.
You worked at the River Cafe for
you. I did.
Were you in the kitchen or front of house?
I was front of house, but at the River Cafe, they get you to prep all their vegetables every day.
How long did you work there?
About 6 years.
Wow.
Yeah. We're doing years and years. On the side.
Mm-hmm. So, what did you? Lots of celebrities in there.
Yes, had.
He's met everyone.
I've met everyone. I was a proper rock star back
then.
Arnie.
Schwarzenegger.
Chris Martin.
Gwyneth. He danced with Gwyneth Paltrow.
I danced with Gwyneth.
What do you mean you danced with her?
She came to our Christmas party.
Why?
That's a good question. I'm not sure. Maybe she just didn't get an invite to other parties.
Was Jamie Oliver there then?
He came in quite a lot.
Did he?
Yeah. Okay. My mate Jamie.
Your mate Jamie?
Yeah. Hi, Jamie.
All right. What did Arnie eat? Please say steak.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he got a steak.
Steak, all right. What are we making
now? We're going to make a marinated watermelon and feta salad. So we've got the marinade, we've got some honey, some tahini, we've got some oil, we've got some light oil, we've got rice vinegar, we've got some lime, and we've got some watermelon. Then we have some pistachios, some cucumbers, some rocket, and some feta.
What are these called again?
I might have stumbled over the word pistachio, but all the hip people are saying that joke. all the kids are saying these
days.
I asked Ollie and Mikey what the cool kids are saying, and they said that's how we say it now. So what we do first of all, Mikey, what I need to do is to make this marinade. So all of those ingredients, and we want the zest and the juice of the lime into that bag.
Zest
meanwhile,
and juice.
What we do with the watermelon, we want nice cubes of this.
Oh, why have I forgot the hard one?
Oh, my God.
This is the exciting bit.
Oh, God.
So what we do, it's quite wasteful, this, because I want perfect cubes. So we cut around like that, and then that size. So you just need one more piece, and that will do.
I can do
so
that.
So you're gonna cook this watermelon?
Yeah, so this is what we're doing. So that's the marinade, and here's the watermelon. Let it sit in there. Ideally, you want to sit it in there for a couple of hours. It's not crucial. But what happens is, because we've got some nice ingredients in there, then what we'll get is a bit of charring of the watermelon. So get the pan nice and hot.
What are you doing?
Because you're on TV.
It's kind of...
Sorry.
Hold on, wait. Sorry. Can everyone look away? All right, do it now. You're all right.
No one's watching.
Sorry.
And then what happens?
OK, you can look back now. And Motherwell beats St Johnson's 2-1 in the cup.
And what happens is all of the flavours that we've got in the marinade that Mikey's making go into the watermelon. And because there's a little bit of honey in there, then it means it will caramelise. So we're charring this, and it changes the flavour. If you're going to be fancy about this, basically what you do is you actually put this in a vac pack, so that it compresses the watermelon and it changes the texture. But no one has those.
You changing the technique. It's good though.
And then, with the rest of the marinade, pour that.
Simon. So he's doing triangles, Simon.
And we boil that and we reduce that down to thicken it. Okay, right.
Have we done this all wrong?
I'm making a sculpture.
Watermelon Jenga.
Hey, we've got a good picture of you here. This is you with
all in.
With Rihanna.
All in?
Everything in, yeah.
Here we go, Ollie.
Riri.
Were you gave her the first copy of the album, one of the first copies of the album? Is that true?
That's true, yeah. She has the first ever vinyl of the album, yeah.
Brilliant. And what, you look very excited to meet her. Are you a big fan of hers?
I am, yeah. I'm a really big fan. I've been a fan of hers for ages. So, yeah, it was honestly, I actually don't, because we were performing on the Graham Norton show, but I actually don't remember the whole, I don't remember any of it.
Really?
Because it was such a blur. So, but thankfully I have that photo.
And what was she like?
She was very cool. She was, like, very chill, kind of like you'd imagine she would be, just, like, effortlessly... beautiful.
We can never talk about Rihanna on the show without bringing up the fact that Simon is related to her.
Rihanna.
How is your relationship?
It is a fact.
Can
we
you introduce?
Did a thing on the show ages ago about family trees, and there's some
genealogy type things.
I'm so jealous.
Yeah, and I am related to her.
Wow.
Yeah.
How again? Remind me. How many steps?
It was kind of pretty close. I mean, you know, when I sort of saw the, I kind of dropped her a text to sort of say, what did you think of the album? She's busy. She's not replied yet.
Yeah.
That number seems to be blocked. Yeah. When I kind of send it to her.
Yeah. We had a genealogy expert, and I think it was, that's what they were called, and they just traced Simon somehow to Rihanna. Which
that's
is
so
really
cool. Yeah. That's like the best bizarre. Result you can.
It is pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
The problem is though, if I ever meet her, I'll tell her that, and then I'll get carted away by security.
I'm related to
her! Related, you and I! Security! So, look, this is what happens with this beautiful watermelon. The smell of it is divine. So you get all of this charring going on, and that is what you want. And if you've got loads of time, obviously you'll just char it on every single side. But for us, that's going to be absolutely fine. And when you taste this, you won't believe it's watermelon, because it just changes everything completely. So what we have is the marinade. Then, backtracking. That goes in there.
Whoa.
And then you give that a little cuddle.
Cuddle.
Little massage.
Oh, nice.
And then we seal it up, leave it 20 minutes, then we end up in that state, and then we reduce down. Next job for us, gentlemen, we have the other salad ingredients. So, Ollie, let's get you on knife skills again. So there, what would you with the cucumber? Concentrate is scoop the seeds out and then cut it into pieces that thick.
Okay.
Okay?
I can do that.
Meanwhile, you got this.
Mikey, for you, with the pistachios, all we do is just run the knife across it. You're not trying to make them really, really broken. You're just breaking them down a little bit.
You went to see Alexandra, didn't you, in Sister Act?
Yes, babe. I saw you in Sister Act last year. You are so amazing.
Oh, my gosh.
So amazing.
Thank you.
You're, honestly, your vocal, the whole time I was like, your vocals are so amazing.
Thank
I loved
you,
it.
I didn't know. Yeah. You've got to come see Chicago now.
Oh, yeah.
If you've got time.
I will.
Yeah.
Love to.
Please. Oh, wow. Thank you.
Yeah, no, you're so good.
Oh, really sweet.
Cheers. That was a nice moment.
Yeah.
So what we have, Rocket, we crumble our feta into there. We then have our charred watermelon. Put some of that
in my eye.
Into there. And then what we've done, we've reduced down the marinade so it becomes our dressing. And that has got really lovely flavour as well. That goes into there. And then how are we doing?
That's
beautiful.
This is the best.
So the pistachios, all of the half of those into there, please, Mikey.
Half of those.
And then.
Oh no, my should have been quicker. Oh God!
We're all waiting on you, Ollie. We're all waiting on you. That's beautiful. Perfect. So cucumber goes into there. That's great. How nice is that, wasn't it?
That's amazing.
Isn't it?
That's really weird. What's it taste of, apart from water?
It almost tastes as if it's become. I know, fish or meat, it doesn't taste like a fruit anymore. It changes completely. So what we get, all of these lovely ingredients sit...
Put it on the plate.
...on there. And then, final few bits of watermelon, so everyone can have a little try of that. And but the marinade as well, when you reduce that down, gives a really great flavour. And it's just a simple, delicious thing. Ladies and gentlemen, you want to come across and have a little taste as well? So what we get is that lovely flavour of the charred marinated watermelon. Reducing down that marinade so you get a really nice flavour of the dressing. And it's not even weird. I'm going to say it's weird. It's just a delicious flavour.
Shall I feed my doll?
It's not weird at all.
It's really nice. I've never had cooked watermelon before.
No, cooked watermelon. Really,
you're welcome.
You can have a card in the next one. Thank you, guys. More from you later on. And you perform live at the end of the show.
That tastes good.
Don't forget, for all of today's brunch recipes, head to the website, channel4.com/SundayBrunch. After break, we're chatting to William Cece.
We're joined by Rebecca Sue. Our guests are joining us as well. We're eating cold ice cream in a very hot studio, which we thought was a good idea at the time. But what we're going to do is pass these ones out first, aren't we? Because they are starting to melt. So shall I take one and then?
Hey, we'll pass them on.
They are beautiful.
Oh, they really are.
They are melting.
Watch your expensive clothes.
So, do you want to tell us about this one? Then we'll go back to the history of it all.
This is a vegan sorbet rose by Amarino, which you can find around the UK, including in Leeds. And they make these beautiful roses. You can actually have up to 28 different flavours within one rose from them because they make such amazing, intricate petals. And the lovely thing about this is it includes a chocolate sorbet, which is quite unusual. You don't very often get a vegan chocolate ice cream. I don't really have, I can't really have dairy these days, and so it's amazing to get a chocolate one.
The chocolate in particular tastes very, very creamy.
It's incredibly creamy, and it's amazing what the texture of just chocolate, water, and sugar can do together.
All the flavours
in one.
So
don't feel like you've got to eat the whole thing because you've got another three to try.
What have you been up to since we last saw you?
I've been on holiday. I've had a holiday in France for a week.
That's good.
Yeah, it was really, really nice.
So we're looking at ice creams today, and that's quite nice, isn't it? Do we all like
them? Lovely.
Who invented the ice cream in the first place?
As with so many of these really old foodstuffs, we don't really know. Certainly the ancient Greeks were eating ice flavoured with honey and herbs, and the Chinese, there were very old recipes, 200 BC, for kind of ice-based desserts. And then they might have travelled from China through Asia and into Italy. Or alternatively, the Italians might have invented it in the 1600s. Nobody knows.
OK.
Was vanilla the first flavour?
No, chocolate.
What?
Chocolate was the first flavour, yeah. Well, not one of, not the first, but certainly before vanilla, yeah. So chocolate, coffee and tea were actually the things which were used most to flavour desserts in the 1600s when ice cream started to become a widespread thing.
And how many different forms of ice cream are there?
So many, can't even count. If you think about, like, gelato, sorbet, your regular ice cream, soft serve, you've got things like this, the shaved ice from Korea that we've got coming up. You know, it's like there are almost every culture has a cold, icy dessert.
Should we try this one?
Because I think it's melting.
Can everyone grab one of these? So I'll grab this one. So what is this one?
So this is from a place in central London called Jinju.
Wow.
And this is a bingsu. Which means it's a block of. It's good, isn't it? It's made with matcha green tea.
Oh, that's really weird.
it's a matcha green tea ice cream, and which is a very traditional. Flavour in Korea, and it's made with a block of ice that's then shaved using a special machine, and it creates these amazing ribbons. So it's not whipped or churned like a traditional ice cream would be at all. It's folded in ribbons, and unfortunately it's melted, so you can't totally see the ribbons. And then you've got this lovely sesame and Rice Krispie topping with candied almonds and mochi rice cakes.
You can sort of see the ribbons.
Oh yeah, you can. Nice. Yeah. And in the bottom, there's a red bean paste, a sweet red bean paste, which is another very, very traditional ingredient that you would have.
I really like that.
I hate
matcha normally, but I really like
it's
that.
It's very subtle and beautiful, I think. It's the green tea flavour isn't like overwhelming and bitter or anything.
Ollie, like that?
It's not my fave.
It's quite an unusual taste, isn't it?
It's different.
It is, it's definitely
because of the matcha,
different.
But the matcha works because you've got all the sweet stuff going on with it.
Yeah.
That's why I like it.
Try
I drink
matcha
lattes.
Oh, okay, so it's
why
a familiar flavour.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm waiting for that one.
Right?
Okay. Should we go on to the... That's
great.
So the next one. These are little ice cream sandwiches. These are from the Spice Deli, and these are chai ice cream sandwiches. So chai is an Indian tea blend with ginger and cardamom.
When you buy these, you're going to squidge out, isn't it? So I'm ready.
Yes, remember the old ice cream wafers you had? It all squashes
yes,
out.
Yes, it's exactly that idea. Oh, wow, so these are little biscuits that are very often served with chai in India. And the spicing is just so lovely. They're such a simple little treat, but they're so delicious, aren't they?
I love that.
But you've got to be careful when you're eating it, squirting it out for everybody.
Ice cream seems to be getting more popular at the moment, is it?
Yeah, it's a bit of a thing this year. I mean, obviously we've had such a massive heat wave, which is kind of gone. It was really hot when we planned this item and it was the perfect weather for ice cream, and now it's over. So I think that's partly contributed to it being such a massive thing. But, you know, like all these trends, people are just experimenting, trying to do different things, bringing different cultural favourites together, different flavours.
Tell us about brain freeze.
Brain freeze, yes. Sphenopalatine ganglioneuralgia. It's a very useful rapid onset headache, which happens when you eat ice cream or anything cold too quickly. It's your brain's way of saying, don't do that. Mm-hmm. And it's used in researching treatments for migraines, because it's the only kind of headache that you can start off in the brain without causing anybody any harm. So they use it to stimulate what's going on in the brain during another kind of headache.
How do you get rid of brain freeze?
Don't eat ice cream really quickly.
Put your tongue in the roof of your mouth.
Oh, yes, that's true. Or your tongue.
And it stops brain freeze.
Or your tongue.
Does it?
Yeah.
I think it's to do with the heat of your thumb.
Yeah, so it's there's a load of blood vessels in the top and back of your mouth that have got too cold too quickly. So if you do that with your thumb or your tongue, then you stop that chilling happening and your brain stops reacting to it.
That's a medical fact.
Yeah. I won't go that far. Right. Grab one of those and pass you the half of them down.
So these are ice eclairs. So these are eclairs filled with ice cream. And what could be wrong with that? I think it's such a good idea. These have been created by Melba at the Savoy Hotel. So they're dead posh. So you've got a choux pastry, which has been piped out and baked and then filled with ice cream, and it's rose petals and freeze-dried raspberries and popping candy and a berry coulis and all the good things.
That's insane.
And everybody's happy.
Like, this is worth getting brain freeze for, isn't it?
That's quite spectacular, isn't it?
That? Yeah, it is, isn't it? Yeah, it's really good. So yeah, best of luck.
I don't think this is moderation.
That everything in moderation. And I'm having all this sugar now, and I'm going to really enjoy it. No point in spoiling it. And then maybe give it up tomorrow. Or maybe not. Nice. No, it's just beautiful.
Favourites. All right, let's choose our favourite. Ollie, who's
Ollie, what's your favourite?
The biscuit. That was the biscuit one.
The chai biscuit.
Emma, yeah?
Ditto.
Yeah. Alex?
I'm going to say this one.
Yeah.
The biscuit was great, but this is topped it.
Biscuit.
I like the cornet first, to have your variation of the ice cream and go around and have a different one. But they're all beautiful, well done.
This has blown me away.
I think I'm going with that one.
The matcha.
Yeah, because it's really different. Yeah, I like it. Mm.
Brilliant.
Welcome back to Saturday Brunch Live. We're now joined by Ollie, frontman of electropop trio Years and Years. First of all, congratulations are in order because your track, If You're Over Me, became Brit certified gold this week.
Gold.
what does gold mean in this day and age? How many is that?
I think it's 400,000.
Oh, brilliant.
Wow.
Like combined, because you know no one really buys music, so it's like combined downloads and streams or something.
Right.
But I could be wrong, it's very confusing. But it's good.
Yeah,
so thank you.
And how did you celebrate?
I don't think I have yet. I haven't stopped. But I'm having a lot of fun because we've been doing our show, our Palo Santo new album, new show, all around, and that's like so much fun. It just gives me, life every time.
Well, we were just saying before we came back on air that, you know, you almost know to the day what you're doing for the next 6 months.
Yeah.
I think that must be slightly daunting at times, though.
It's daunting, but there's something nice about it as well, I think, when you're like, oh, well, I'm going to be in this country or I'm going to see Japan. And, you know, if it's exciting stuff, then it's cool. But, yeah, I think as soon as it stops and then I have a bit of free time, I'm like, what do I do with myself?
Yeah.
So.
So you said just mention that Japan. Are you big in Japan?
Big in Japan. No, I wish. I mean, we get to go there. Like, most bands, you know, it's lucky to be able to go out there and play your own show. So we can, but we're not sort of like being chased down the street or anything.
Yeah.
But we, we went to South Korea, and that's where the doll was from that we had on the earlier. Mm. And it felt like we were quite famous in South Korea. It was nuts, like fans at the airport and people running after us and like taking pictures, yeah, so.
What's it like down there?
It's beautiful. I mean, it's really amazing, I think.
It's all really modern.
It seems that way, yeah. It seems like you're living in the future. Everything's super clean. Yeah, everyone's really beautiful.
Okay, and are you also going off to the States when you do your tour?
Yeah, I'm going to the States in October. For the whole month, we'll be touring, and then we come back and do our UK tour in November, December. So come see us.
But if you do something like the States, obviously, you know, it's the biggest market in the world. Is there a bit of... You have a level of kind of notoriety there now. Is it kind of like, right, if we spend a month there, then hopefully...
Oh, in America?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's just so big.
Yeah. don't you really have to go 12 months?
Yeah,
isn't
you
that
do.
Kind of what you have to do?
Put a lot of time in. And it's so far away and it's really expensive to go and tour, all the boring things. But we haven't, you know, every time we go there, we have really great shows. Like, people come and see us, you know. So it's kind of like, it's still a great experience to go and tour there for us. But yeah, we're probably not about to be the next like NSYNC, unfortunately. But we might be still.
Yeah.
Right, tell us about your videos now. We're about to show If You're Over Me. The videos are linked, aren't they, in a way?
You know, we did a little storyline. So yeah, the first video kind of is Sanctify, and then If You're Over Me is kind of like a part two. And then we released a short film with the album that kind of tells the story of linking them together. And yeah.
Okay, well, let's have a look. This is If You're Over Me.
1 minute you say you're a thief, then you're telling me you can't breathe. Well, you should set me free, baby, if you're over me. Yesterday you said I'm the one, but now you say you're done. Stop telling me what I need, baby, if you're over me. If you're over me, if you're over me. Stop telling me what I need, baby, if you're over me.
Okay, so explain that. That's the video, and then you've got the film Palo Santo, which is a short film. We're going to show a clip of that in a minute. So explain what's happening in the whole thing.
Okay, so Palo Santo is the name of this place, a fictional place that's thousands of years in the future. And in Palo Santo, it's predominantly like run by androids, and these androids are superhuman-like. They look like humans, sound like humans, but they can't fall in love. They can't eat. They don't sleep. And they're really obsessed with their human ancestors. So they search the world to find the few remaining humans, and then they bring them to Palo Santo, and they make them these like huge celebrities, and they perform for their androids. So all the androids come because they want to experience like real human emotion.
Are you an android or a human?
I'm a human.
Right, okay. Yeah. You've got an amazing amount of people who've turned up for your film, haven't you?
Oh, I pulled in quite a few favours, yeah.
Go on, name check some of the people in it.
Judi Dench.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good. Yeah, that's probably the... there we are. And Ben Whishaw, we got him a little cameo in it. I begged them to do it, and they did.
I also think, you know, the band is almost seems like it's one part of you. That whole creative process is you. The dance, the narrative of it, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It feels like years and years isn't just releasing CDs and getting up on stage.
Yeah, no, totally. I think, you know, how I just, before the second album began and everything, I was like, oh, what would be the most kind of creatively inspiring thing to do, and like what excites me, and what are the artists that I love, you know, like Prince and Bowie and Lady Gaga, and they create these whole worlds, you know, that is just unique to them, and it's an experience. And just think, why not, if you have this opportunity, you know, to create your own music videos, create your own live show, like why not just make something really, you know, unusual and ambitious, and, you know, something that you'll love, that I love.
So. Okay. Going back to the short film Palo Santo, we've got a clip of it here. So
yay!
Grace, virtue. Welcome to Palo Santo Android Solutions. Our creations hold a mirror to the best of humanity.
A new candidate arrives. Please us, enrapture us, but do not bore us. We want to feel. We want to feel. We want to feel.
Wow. So you used to be an actor.
Yes.
You're still an actor, obviously. That you must have thoughts of turning that into a proper film.
I would love to. Yeah, it'd be so fun. But it'd be quite a lot of money. someone needs to give me some money. anyone's watching Netflix?
Yeah. Not our viewers. our viewers are busy collecting train tickets.
Yeah, it's nice.
So, are you going to do any more acting? No, you can't. You haven't got time, have you?
Oh, quite busy, yeah. But, you know, if it was something that was really cool, then, you know, I'd love to.
Did you get the buzz back, though, filming the short film?
Well, do you know what? I really just want to have magic powers in something, so I'm just be like, magic. Do you know what I mean? Be like, do that, and then something would happen, or like, do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Or be like in a sci-fi movie. Like, I would love to do that. So, yeah. I think, yeah, I'm not. I don't have like Oscar hopes or anything, but yeah, something fun could be cool.
Brilliant. Thanks, Ollie. Years and years. Album Palo Santo is out now. There it is. And you and the rest of the boys will be performing it live at the end of the show.
Just a moment, we learn about the history of the Highland Games. But first, Jamie Oliver
struggles... The what games? The Highland Games.
The Highland Games. But first, Jamie Oliver struggles, like me, to shame him in a pasta-making masterclass. This is Jamie Cook's Italian.